Hallelujah. I want to call your attention to our word today that comes from the gospel recorded by St. Luke, the fourth chapter, verses 16 through 19. Chapter 4, verses 16, Luke 4, 16. Luke 4, and he came to Nazareth where he had been brought up. And as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are oppressed, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." And I don't think that that can be a better message concerning homecoming than the text we have today. And oh, what a text, because it speaks to the season that we are going through right now. Oh, how we rejoice and give thanks and praise God for the Biden victory and the Kamala Harris vice president, because we were going through some dark days, dismal days, demonic days, a dark cloud was hanging over this world, not just this nation, but over this world, foreboding and looming to bring even worse havoc. Amen. And destruction that's been felt around the world, especially when it comes to this pandemic. Who has ever seen anybody with a crisis on hand not give their double best to save human life? That's just a part of what we were facing. But thanks be unto God. I praise God for our ancestors who said that harder yet may be the fight. Right may often yield to might. Wickedness a while may reign. Satan's cause may seem the gain, but there is a God. Hallelujah. You ought to say, there is a God who rules above with a hand of power and a heart of love. And if you're right, he'll fight your battle. If we shall be free someday. That is a hymn by the late Charles A. Taylor entitled "Beams of Heaven." As I go through this wilderness, below, guide my feet in peaceful ways. Turn my midnight into days when in the darkness I would grow. Faith always see. Hallelujah. You got to excuse my rejoicing this morning, but I just thank God for faith and trust in Jesus. And I'll make it out all right. And oh, yesterday we saw a day of jubilation. Hallelujah. We saw shouting. Oh, yes, I did. I saw black and white together. They voluntarily and spontaneously came out of their homes, out of their classrooms, all over this nation. Yes, and all over the world. Amen, because God's truth was marching on. As Julia Ward Howe wrote that song, Yes, I've seen the lightning flash. I've heard the thunder's roar. I've felt sin breakers dashing, trying to conquer my soul. But I've heard the voice of Jesus.
Yes, he promised.
Never to leave us. Not just in America, not just in Europe, but he promised mankind all over the world never to leave us alone. Aren't you glad that you serve a universal God?
Hallelujah.
Glad that you serve a God who sits high and looks low. And
hallelujah.
Might have said he sees all we do. He hears all we say. My God is a writing all the time. And I join today. My heart is happy. My heart is overflowing. I rejoice. Excuse me for rejoicing. Because as Van Jones of MSNBC, he said that he wanted to tell his sons to look at this, to realize
yes,
that
Lord. Yes.
Does matter, that truth does matter. Amen. And I, well, when he talked, his heart that swelled up with such exuberance and such emotion. I prayed that he wouldn't lose it. He did lose it. But thank you, yes. God. He spoke for oppressed people. Oh, I wish you could feel what he felt. He spoke, yes, for the downtrodden. He spoke for the maligned. He spoke, yes, he spoke for Jesus. Because that's what Jesus said here in our text, to set the captives free. Now, setting the captives free, this is the scripture that Jesus recited from Isaiah chapter 61 when he went back, and they wondered what was he about. And he told them the first thing, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. Oh, I don't know whether you got the religion or not, but I say to the America, pray for Joe Biden and pray for Kamala Harris, because I do believe in the bottom of my heart that the Spirit Amen. Of the Lord God is upon him. I felt he was the only man.
Amen.
Around from going down into the cave of darkness and bring up to the mountaintop of the light and the glory of God. So I believe he has the Spirit of God. And second, I believe he's anointed by God. Yes, I believe. Oh, I don't know about you, but I thank God for the power of our faith. And not just African Americans, because this phrase does not America, but they used to say God moves in mysterious ways. His wonders. He plants his foot on every sea and rides on every storm. I'm telling you, it was storming in this land. It was storming in America. It was storming all over the world.
Hallelujah.
God is involved. God does not sit up in heaven and let the devil have the hindmost.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I believe God is involved in this. Yes, I believe God moves. Yes, I do. Yes, he moved through you. And look at them hands. Hands that we thought didn't matter. Hands that felt that the vote didn't count. But what turned the tide? It was the hand of God on human hands that turned the tide. Mm-hmm. Amen. And when the count came in, from Arizona and Pennsylvania. I don't know about you, but I thank God that was there.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
You can Hallelujah. Get
through. You can be sad if you want to, but you got to say a better day is coming. And that's what our sermon is all about. That the better day is coming. Amen. One commentator said that America had come home to its foundation, come home to its roots, come home to its principles, come home to its values. That's what home is all about, the value. Amen. And so, yes, and then Jesus not only said the Spirit of God is upon me, not only is it upon Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, we got to lift up our heads. Amen. We got to open up our eyes and open up our hearts and realize that God is going to use you and me that we might have a better world, a better day. Amen. And Jesus said, second, he had not left me alone. He had not left me in my own might, not left me in my own power, but he has anointed me. Yes, what is their anointing, Reverend? The anointing is of the indwelling presence and the power of the Holy Ghost that revitalizes us and energizes us and enlivens us and renews our strength. Yes, it does. Renews our strength. I think about when he hit that stage yesterday at 7 to 8 years of age. Great God Almighty. He was so renewed.
Hallelujah.
By the Spirit of God, he came running. Yes, he does. They that wait upon the Lord, though they run, they'll not get weary. They'll walk and not faint. And so the anointing of God is upon America. Yes, you can not recognize it if you like, but yes, his anointing is upon this land, because this land, the world looks to this land to be a light to the nations around the world. And so much so, one of the heads of state from France said, welcome back, or the word welcome home. Yes, and I thank God for his anointing, because he not only anoints your hand, he anoints your heart, he anoints your eyes, that you may be able to see his truth marching on. When she said, mine eyes have seen the glory of the Lord. He's trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed his fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. And oh, legend in his song picked up that song, glory, hallelujah. You can't tell me God ain't real. Yes, God is real. Yes, I don't have to just only be the one that feel it in my soul. And his truth is marching on. And I thank God he closes with that fourth stanza. In the beauty of the lilies, he was born across the sea with the glory in his bosom that transfigured you and me as he died, talking about Jesus, to make men holy. Let us die to make men free. God's truth is marching on. And then not only does he anoint, but the thing that all of us are witnesses of, and we have experienced, he has sent me, yes, to heal. I believe Joe Biden, this sermon is not about Joe Biden, but I believe he's an instrument. Yes, he's an instrument of healing. Yes, he is. I believe that because that's what God wishes to heal the land, not just from from seed to shining soil, the seed to shining soil, because he's come to heal the brokenhearted. And we realize that there are broken hearts all across the country, all around the world. Yes, you and I have been broken, but we can thank God that we have somebody named Jesus. Can you say Jesus? Yes, name Jesus.
Jesus.
Yes, he heals the brokenhearted. Yes, the Bible says it's the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. I don't know about you, but I serve a God who's a healer. Yes, I've gone to him many a time, brokenhearted, cast down, cast out, trampled underfoot. Yes, I have. I felt like sometimes I was nothing but a rug on the floor, but I say to him, fix me, Jesus, fix me. Fix me, yes, that I can walk right. Fix me, I can live right. Fix me, I can talk right. So, yes, Jesus came to heal the brokenhearted. Yes, if you're brokenhearted today, yes, take your burdens to the Lord and he will work on them. Yes, I'm not going to say leave them there, because sometimes your burdens hold on to you so tight, yes, until you seem to can't get rid of them. But thanks be unto God if you give them to God. Yes, and trust and never doubt. He will surely, yes, somebody can say, surely, surely, surely he has brought me out. Surely he turned things around. Surely he made things better. Surely he opened a door. Surely he raised up friends. Yes, he does. And then the last thing I want to say, he said to proclaim captive liberty to the captive, not only to heal, yes, not only to the anointed, be an anointed, and not only to heal, but to set at free those who are bruised, set the captives free. And they're those, yes, man, we are born in sin and shaped in iniquity. And without Christ in our lives, we are captives, yes, to the power of sin. And we are captive to the power of Satan. But thanks be unto God. All you got to do is come to Jesus just as you are, weary, worn, and sad. Trust in him with all your heart, and yes, he will make you glad. I hear the hymn writer said, I came to Jesus as I was, weary, worn, and sad. What did you do when you came to Jesus? I found in him a resting place, and he has made me glad. He turned my sorrow into joy. He turned my darkness into light. He turned my burdens into flight. Yes, he does. We serve a miracle working God.
Yes, yes, we do. Hallelujah.
We serve a God who can do
miracle working.
He has all power. I hear him saying, as he rose from the grave, I have all power in my hand.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The keys. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The keys out of the hand of the devil. Yes, he did it. Praise Jesus God. Had the keys of death, hell, and the grave. And so we thank God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank
praise
you, Jesus.
The Lord.
Hallelujah.
God. No more chains binding me. So we give God thanks. Praise for homecoming. And Yeah, and that you come today. We pray that you've not made Jesus your choice. You have not accepted him as your Lord and your Savior. You will hear the words of the old saints when they sang together, come to Jesus, come to Jesus. I heard that song as a little boy. Oh, hallelujah. And when they said he will save you, I knew he would make a way for me.
Yes.
I knew he would receive me.
Oh, God, he would not reject me.
I knew he would put his arms around
Hallelujah.
Me. If you don't have him in your life, oh, don't let the burden of any cast your burden upon the Lord.
Amen.
He will set you free. He'll put running in your feet. Oh, yeah.
Amen.
My testimony. I don't mind. I know I'm on virtual. Yes. And but wherever you are, you ought to be able to rejoice.
With Hallelujah.
Amen.
Put clapping in your hand. He does. Doorbells ringing deep down in your soul.
Joy of the Lord. Amen.
Don't care how far down you may feel. Don't care how bad you may feel. Yes, how you may feel that you're worth nothing. Yes, he will. He'll reach down where you are.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Oh, how do you know, Reverend?
Hallelujah.
Because
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh,
and if he can pick it up like me.
Hallelujah. I was lost and I found out God and his son.
He can do
anything.
Yes, but prayer. Our God is able.
Thank you, Lord.
Surely he's able. Amen.
Yes, he's a way maker.
Thank you, Lord.
One day he made a way for me.
Yes, he did.
Thank you.
When I passed
each and every one of us,
Jesus came along and he answered our prayer.
Yes.
Do we have any witnesses out there that can
say, Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Wherever you go, as you walk the streets, as you street corner, as you come down elevators, as you walk the hallway.
Yes, Lord.
He made a way for me.
Yes, he did.
Thank God I got to say this.
Amen.
This man I tell you about all the time. Yes, as I see him out on the sidewalk when I walk in the morning.
Yes.
I'm so blessed. When I walk in my neighborhood, I see church doors open. I see food being given out during the weekend. This brother, he used to have his head hung down. Always asked me for a dollar when he wanted some coffee. Well, I did give him the coffee, but the dollar, and I saw him yesterday. He had the bright light, of truth.
Amen.
I congratulated him and I told him, you're on your way. Yes, keep on journeying and trusting in Jesus.
Amen.
He will bring you out. Amen. He will bring you out.
Amen. Amen. Yes, he will. Amen.
Trust him and never die.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Don't care how dark it gets.
Yes.
Amen. Never doubt. He will surely
bring you out.
Bring you out.
Hallelujah.
Take your burdens.
Take you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You're not going to stay in it. Hallelujah. God take you through it.
Have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. Yes. Look at me. I don't know where I'd be if it had not been for Jesus in my life. Every child of God can tell you the same thing. He has brought you every step of the way. And even if you don't know him as your Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Father. Amen.
Just to where you are today, he is smile on you. And all you got to do is acknowledge